Hey guys, in this video, we're gonna talk about what is band locking and show you how to do it. Now in this video today, I wanna walk you through a Pepwave device and how you can specify what channel you want to connect to on a certain provider, or if you're having issue with a particular channel or a band, how to ignore that particular channel. Now, one quick note here is if you were sent this video by us over in customer support or something, it might be because you've already messed with your bands and you didn't change it to auto when you left your last site. I'll get into that more in a minute, but if you've already kind of messed with this and you're coming back to this video for troubleshooting, make sure you put it back to auto when you're done. So, all right, now let's get into it. So band locking is the ability to basically select a channel that your device connects to. Each location, each tower, they can all have different channels, different bands. Certain networks have different bands. I don't want to get into all of that here. I really just want to show you what and how to do it band locking. So let's jump into the computer and I'll show you how to do that. Okay, now I have connected to my Pepwave's Wi-Fi. I have logged in to the dashboard. If you need help with those steps, you can check out this video up here. But let's give you a quick overview, kind of the lay of the land of where we are. So I am using a Transit Duo. That is the device that is in the Ultimate Road Warrior package. Basically, the main difference here is I'm going to have two active cell connections I can use at the same time. Other devices probably just have one. And you'll see I have Wi-Fi as WAN on and enabled as a feature. I am testing a future unit, which will be labeled Transit 5G here. More to come in a couple videos later, but so that's just a future device for us. And really what I want to do is I'm going to pick on Verizon. If I was doing testing and I was feeling like the speeds were really slow and I was connected to Verizon, I knew that was where my issue was from. What I would do is I could go into details here and then I can scroll down to this main section. I can see band. So I'm connected to actually two bands with Verizon, a primary band of 66 and then a secondary band of 2. I can get their RSSI, which is, think of it like your bars, your signal strength is there. And I can kind of get all of those readings and information here. Now, for this particular example, I actually want to disable band 66. Let's say I'm having issues with it for whatever reason. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to go to band selection. And when I hit custom on that dropdown, I get an option basically of all the bands that we have enabled. To keep it simple, all we're going to do is we're going to uncheck band 66. Go down and hit save and apply. And then we're gonna let the system load for a second because it's probably gonna drop our connection because we're saying don't use this band anymore. So the modem is gonna go see if there's other bands in the area it can connect to. It's probably gonna take a second. Yeah, so we did lose connectivity. It went to connecting. We're just gonna let it kind of reconnect that modem and we're gonna see what we get. So that was really quick. I didn't even probably have to fast forward this video much. If we hit details now on Verizon, we're going to see it's now at band 13, and it's even actually a better signal than it was before, and we've changed to another secondary band, which you'd expect. So that would be a quick way to change it. Now, what's super important is remember when you move locations to turn it back to auto. You're going to want to probably be traveling with it on auto. So as you move, all of the bands can be connecting, especially as you move around. And when you get to your new site, you might need to start over your troubleshooting again, if you even need to. Now, the night before or whenever I'm ready and I'm kind of done with the internet for this particular location, I'll come back in here. I'll hit back to auto. I'll hit save and apply, and then I am done. And that means it will be automatic next time we go. And if I need to re-troubleshoot and I need to do band selection again in the future, that's fine. But I know the system is best set on auto for most locations, and it's going to kind of pick us up from there. So, all right, that is the main selection for bands. Now, a couple key notes and a couple key things, key bands that we like to talk about. So the first one is going to be FirstNet, which for a lot of Pepwave devices, it does pick up. For my particular one, the Transit Duo, I do pick up the FirstNet band, which is band 14, if you have AT&T. And so for example, if I wanted to pick up just band 14, I can go down and actually looks like I'm already connected to band 14. So I wouldn't need to necessarily do anything here. But if I wanted to force it to band 14, if I saw it jumping a lot, I would do the same steps. I'd go down to band selection. I would hit custom And in this particular case, I would just uncheck everything until only band 14 was selected. And then it would basically be locking my particular modem to band 14. And this way I'm just forcing it onto that particular one. Now, while although this might help you if something happens to band 14 or this particular channel gets cluttered or saturated, it doesn't really have an option now to switch to a different network or a different band. So just be aware, while though it might fix it temporarily, it could cause longer term problems. So only do this if you really feel it's necessary. Now, another band to be aware of is band 71. That one is a T-Mobile band. Now, my particular router in this demo does not support band 71, but you will find that in the Speed Demon, which is the Pepwave Transit Cat 18 unit, and the future 5G models that Pepwave is putting out. Those will all support the band 71, from what we know at this point. And so you could band lock to that if you felt that that was necessary or needed based on your connection type. But for the most part, we suggest auto unless you feel it's necessary. All right, guys, that's it. This is a short one for today. Thank you, and we'll see you in the next video.